Hey everyone, this is Comicsthetic, and over the course of the last few days, we've gotten a lot of news for various MCU and just general Marvel projects. So I thought I'd compile everything we've learned over the last few days and tell you. Starting off, we learned that Blade is officially going to be rated R. We actually learned this from the director of the film. The director has said that he's excited to unleash Mahershala Ali's ruthlessness and roughness now that the film has been given an R rating. I think this is wonderful news. I think Blade is one of those characters that typically you associate with a little bit more darkness, a little bit more violence. And this R rating, coupled with the less than $100 million budget that we learned about, I think, as well as actually the new script writer, the same writer from Logan, has all the makings of a fantastic film. I think all of the pieces have finally fell into place for this film. Sad that it took quite a minute, but I'm glad that all the pieces are finally together because I truly believe we're going to have a great film on our hands. On the Disney Plus side of things, we actually have news regarding a new series. And this isn't connected to the Vision Quest series we've been hearing rumors about. We have news that a Wiccan series is in the works, and that it will focus on Billy searching for his brother Tommy with help from a friend, and is likely to be set up during the events of Agatha, which I think makes sense, and I think that's actually who the friend is in reference to. I think this is cool. I'm excited to see these two actually grow up and get their abilities and be full on Wiccan and speed. Hope eventually we get to see Hulkling alongside Tommy or Billy, and hopefully they eventually reunite with their mother. Disney has confirmed that What If Season 2 will actually be releasing this holiday season, and that's on rather short notice, so we are likely due for a trailer sometime this month. I'm actually excited for Season 2. I think there were a lot of great parts of Season 1 that get overlooked for the bad, which seems to happen a lot in the MCU, and I'm excited to see how they spin some more stories, and I think there's been some really interesting rumors, and we even have an original character debuting in What If Season 2, so I'm excited about that aspect. Speaking of trailers, it has been reported from Daniel RPK that we're due soon for a Madame Web trailer. Now, it was originally reported that it could be in the next few days, but that has since likely shifted because of Netflix's Geek Week thing, and now it seems more likely that we'll be getting it next week. So, I'm actually curious about this movie, which I know is a scary thing to have when you're regarding Sony's Spider-Man universe, but I think they have the makings of a actually good film on their hands. I mean, they're actually using spider heroes as the main characters rather than villains turned heroes for some odd reason. I'm just really curious what this film's about, what's its purpose besides just being a cash grab for Sony, and how it connects to everything in that universe, as well as maybe, who knows, the MCU. Sony's always trying to get their hands in that pool. So, I'm curious, and I'm going to go into it with an open mind. This time around, the news actually comes from Deadpool 3. And another rumor from Daniel RPK stating that Blade will actually appear in Deadpool 3. Although he does not know in what capacity or which version. I'm not sure if it would be Mahershala Ali's. I don't know how that would connect, really, and how that would really tie into anything. I would guess it would be Snipes' version, because there's a whole multiversal cameo from past heroes motif going on, but there's no real way to be certain. The final bit of news we have today comes yet again from Daniel RPK. He's just the gift that keeps on giving. And he actually states that Michael Keaton will be returning as Vulture in Spider-Man 4. And this is easily my favorite piece of news that has come out this week. Spider-Man 4 is probably my most hyped MCU project as of now, even beyond Secret Wars and Deadpool 3 and everything. So to hear this news got me incredibly excited, because that means he's going to be, I mean, hopefully one, this just means they're ignoring that stupid post-credit scene for Morbius and that film altogether. But two, are we going to see him as the Vulture again, or is he going to be in kind of more of a subdued role? Is he with Kingpin as the main villain, it seems, as some people have suggested? Is he going to be putting together these villains and Scorpion and Prowler and Vulture to, as kind of a pseudo Sinister Six? Or is it going to be maybe more of a, he's taking more of the Adrian Toomes route? Is he going to be playing the broken father who's lost his way with his, you know, and he regrets his past? Michael Keaton played a fantastic Vulture. He's one of the best Spider-Man villains on screen, and I can't wait to see what his return has in store. And I'm just excited for Spider-Man 4 in general. Like I said, my most anticipated MCU project, anything MCU Spider-Man is my most anticipated part of the MCU. So I can't wait to see how this all unfolds. Thank you for watching. This has been Comicsthetic, and we've got a lot of exciting updates about the MCU and just comic book movies in general. And hopefully with these strikes ending soon, we'll be getting a lot more. Everyone can't wait for Deadpool 3 to get back to filming, for Spider-Man 4 to start filming, and for us to finally get the Fantastic Forecast. Regardless, I'm just ecstatic that we live in a time with so much comic book content in all forms, not just these movies. And I'm happy to be able to share my excitement with all of you. Thank you for watching.